What is the status and indeed the quality of leadership in the country today as we mark 51 years of independence of Tanganyika?
Thank you very much. I think the thing today is very important for our national development. To talk of the status of leadership today, I think we need to look at the development of leadership in this country, two phases of leadership. Particularly, we have the phase of the Arusha Declaration, and we have the phase of the post-Arusha Declaration, or the phase of liberalism. So I think this comparison can help us. My follow-up shows that the period of the Arusha Declaration, and because there was a clear ideology, the ideology of socialism and self-reliance, and that clear ideology put a direction, a national direction, where the nation was going. So leaders were prepared to become leaders with the commitment, with the objectives towards that direction. That's why during that period, you had the type of leadership which had a high level of commitment for the nation, high level of commitment for the nation, for the people, for development. And of course, following leadership ethics, which were there laid down in the Arusha Declaration. Now this, the phase of liberalism, there have been drastic changes. First, one is the loss of direction.
Loss of direction.
Loss of direction, because we had to throw away the Arusha Declaration, and it would be thrown away, the leadership principles which were based there.
But it was replaced by the Zanzibar Revolution.
Declaration. There is nothing there which gives a direction, a national direction, and a national ideology. You see? So that has created a big change. It has also affected the nature and the character of leadership. That's why because one indicator of leadership is the level of corruption.
Okay.
That's a very important indicator. So the level of corruption now is very high. That means we have a leadership. People aspire to become leaders. Not so much they should lead this nation and the people towards somewhere.